These are coin stamp problems. So the first thing we want to look at is what happens with money. Well, if you have 25 quarters and you want to find out how many cents there are, how many pennies there actually are here, you take the number of coins you have and you multiply it to the value of a quarter. One quarter is 25 cents, so 25 times 25 is 625. 625 cents. And that's the main idea. It's the value times the number of coins. Okay, so let's try a problem. Sylvia found some coins while looking under her sofa pillows. There were equal number of nickels and quarters and twice as many half dollars as quarters. If she found $2.60 in all, then how many of each denomination of coin did she find? So the first thing you want to do is write out the different types of coins you have and then assign a value. So a nickel is 5 cents, and we're going to do everything in terms of pennies. A quarter is 25 cents and a half dollar is 50 cents. And the bank is worth $2.60. That's her total value of each coin. So now all we need is the number of, and that's where our variable is going to come in. So there should be some translation that we've done before, like this. Here. Okay. There were equal number of nickels as quarters, twice as many half dollars as quarters. So if you see quarters being used a lot, that means the quarters has to be our variable because the other two are being represented using quarters. So it says there were equal number of nickels as quarters. So that means they're the same. And twice as many half dollars. So that makes it 2x. All right. And that's all we need. Now we can use the rule we know. We know we take the value times the number of nickels. That's what we did here to find the total value. So that's 5x plus 25x plus 100x equals 260. Add them all up. Divide. And x is 2. X represents the number of nickels. So that means we have 2 nickels, 2 quarters, and twice as many half dollars. So 4 half dollars. And that's our answer. How do we know we're correct? We just do a quick check. So that means we have 2 nickels. We have 2 quarters. And we have 4 half dollars, and these all have to add up to 260. So let's see what we have. That's 10 cents, that's 50 cents, and that's 200 for a total of 260. Checks out perfectly. And those are coin stamp problems. They're all the same. So let's try another one. Read it to yourself, and here we go. So there are pennies. They're 1 cent each. There's dimes. Those are 10 cents each. And the total bank is $2.64. Now, anytime they give you a total, you make one of them x, the other one's 39 minus x. You can probably see this pattern going now with every single word problem. So x, 39x. And then we multiply. Solve it. And write the answer. So x represents the number of pennies. So we have 14 pennies. And then 39 minus 14 is 25 dimes. Circle it and check it. And there we have it. So there are 3 problems for you to try on the back. I'll work through the first one very slowly, and then I'll give you 2 more to try all by yourself. So read the problem and then see if you can fill in the table. Hit pause. And this is what you should have gotten. So we have 3 times as many of the 5 cent as 32, and 5 more of the 15 cent stamps than the 32. So everything was in terms of 32. So that was where the x goes. All right, now you can just solve it. So you should get 5, which is the number of 32 cent stamps. There's 3 times as many as that. So 3 times 5 is 15 for the 5 cents. And there's 5 more than the 5, so that's 10 of the 15 cent stamps. And then now just check it, and we get 385, which is our answer. All right. So hopefully you've gotten the pattern down. Try the next 2 I'm just going to write the answers for them one at a time. So hit pause and try them. And there's your answer, 33 pennies, 27 dimes. Checks out perfectly. Try the next one. And there's the answer. Thank you.